Good morning, guys. It's so good to be with you again. It's time for TK, and that is a good time. So today we're doing something a little different. We like to mix it up every once in a while. Today, instead of looking forward, we're looking back. And it's good to look back. In fact, we're looking all the way back 1 year, and it's good to remember what we did. This happened last year, August 2nd, which is really tomorrow, a year ago tomorrow. Isn't that amazing? You'll see how even we look a little different as a team in 1 year. So here's the thing, guys. We've been studying the life of Jesus, and Jesus taught us important things. He taught us by example, and one of the things he taught us was how we can pray, and praying is very important. In fact, he gave us a prayer that we call the Lord's Prayer. I hope you guys remember it, but if you don't, this is going to be a refresher, because today we're talking about God is wonderful. He's so amazing. He's so much bigger than we can imagine. And even though he's so big, the Bible tells us he knows how many hairs we have on our heads. God is wonderful. And we're going to celebrate that with one of my favorite songs. So everybody stand up. Come on. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. All right, guys, it's time to worship. Let's stand up.
My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God.
Big and so love singing that song together about the Lord's Prayer. And today we're talking about the next part of the Lord's Prayer, about how God is wonderful. Why don't we all say that together? Ready? God is wonderful. That comes from the part of the Lord's Prayer that comes after Our Father who art in heaven. And it says, hallowed be thy name. That's a really weird phrase. Hallowed be thy name. When I think of the word hollow, I think of like something empty. Then I'm looking down and I go, hello down there. I don't know what those words mean. Well, hallowed be thy name is basically talking about how God's name fills us with awe and wonder. How he is so amazing. How God is wonderful. And I think about, there are so many things, right, that fill us with awe and wonder and are cool. And I want to show you a little science experiment that fills me with wonder. So I'm going to put on my scientific glasses and we are going to do a science experiment. Let's do it. Experiment that just made my mind explode with how cool that was. And that I can explain the science behind that thing that filled me with wonder. The little jar that I put in there that had the red food coloring in it was full of hot water. The rest of it was full of cold water. And so because it was so hot, it drew it up and it rose to the surface of the water, creating that cool, what I like to call kind of a volcano-y effect, right? So I can explain that science experiment to you, but when we say the words, hallowed be thy name, there are some things about God that we just don't understand and fill us with awe and wonder, because God is all-knowing and all-powerful. The way he's all-knowing, right? There's a Bible verse that says, God knows every hair on your head. I want you to turn to someone next to you and try and count all the hairs on their head. I'm gonna try and count all of Doug's hair. You ready? Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 10,003, 10,004. 10,005. Yeah, you know what? I'm not going to be able to count all the hairs on his head. I have no idea. But you know what? God, without even counting, knows every hair that's on my head, on your head, even on Doug's head. And God is also all powerful, right? What's the heaviest thing that you can think of? And I want you to shout it out. The heaviest thing you can think of. Let me hear it. Wow, when I think of heavy things, I think about this couch, I think about huge boulders. I can't lift those, right? I'm not that powerful. But God, he could lift whatever he wants, and he also performs amazing miracles, which we're gonna watch a video about one in just a sec. But because of that, God is so wonderful, and his name is hallowed, it's sacred, it's holy. He fills us with wonder. That's why we say that God is wonderful. Let's say it one more time together. Ready? God is wonderful. So let's check out this Bible story that talks a little bit more about how God is wonderful and how powerful he is when we call out and worship his holy name. Check it out.
Stories of the Bible. The walls of Jericho. This is Joshua.
Oh, hey.
Joshua was the leader of the Israelites, who God used to bring his people to the promised land.
Yeah, let's do it.
When God told Joshua it was time to take the promised land, Joshua sent spies into the city of Jericho. While those spies were in Jericho,
come on,
they were protected by a woman named Rahab.
Oh,
The spies promised to spare Rahab and her family when they took back the land.
Yay!
And she hung a scarlet cord from her window to remind them of their promise.
See you soon!
Now the Israelites had crossed the Jordan and were camped near the town of Jericho.
Hey!
Hello!
One day, Joshua looked up, and there was a man standing before him.
Hello.
The man said, "I am the commander of the army of the Lord." Joshua asked what the man wanted to tell him, and the Lord said he wanted Joshua to take the city of Jericho.
All right.
But that Joshua needed to follow his instructions exactly.
You got it.
Jericho was shut for fear of the Israelites.
Anyone home? Anyone?
No one came out and no one came in. So the Lord told Joshua to gather his soldiers and march around the city for 6 days. The priests were to take the Ark of the Covenant, and 7 priests were to go in front of it, blowing a ram's horn. On the 7th day, they were to march around the city 7 times and blow the horn. Then all the people of Israel were to give a great shout.
Then what?
And then the city walls would fall.
Whoa! Yeah, let's do it!
So Joshua said, "Shout, for the Lord has given you the city." And the people did shout.
Yeah!
And the walls did fall.
Let's go!
The Israelites overtook the city of Jericho as God had commanded.
Rahab!
They remembered Rahab because of her faithfulness. Joshua was faithful in carrying out God's commands, and the Israelites took many other cities as God told them they would.
Oh, nice!
For God will never fail to fulfill his promises. So the Israelites came to live in the land that God had promised Abraham, Isaac, Israel, Joseph, and Moses many years ago.
Let's talk about it. Come on in. I'll see you inside. Come on in.
So guys, what were you doing out there?
Well, all right, dear, you tell her. I'm too afraid.
Well, it's very simple, MJ. We were just gonna break down the wall of your house.
Well, that means my whole house would fall down.
Oh. Oh.
I didn't think of that. Did you, Theo?
Oh, I know. No, I didn't. MJ, we don't want to do that to you.
Well, where that idea came from where? What made you think of that?
Theo?
All right. I'm sorry.
Was it from that video that we saw about the walls of Jericho and Joshua?
Well, it was kind of exciting to see. And Theo said, hey, I don't think MJ would mind if we did it at her house.
That's right. You're right, Freddy. It's all my fault. I thought we could just try it just like the Israelites did. But we failed.
Well, let me tell you, let's not say that you failed, because that's not entirely true. You saw a story. You can come over here and do everything you want to anytime, but you can't knock down the house, okay? So that's really, really huge. Now, did God tell you to come over and knock down the wall to my house?
No.
Well, see, that's the first thing. See, God made promises that he had to keep to the Israelites. And so he promised Jericho to them. And so they did what they had to fulfill that promise. So Joshua actually heard God speak. So that's the first thing. God makes promises to all of us. Let's think about some promises God has made to us. God says anytime we come to him, he's there for us, right? God is so wonderful that when we come to him, he's there for us. What are some times that we've gone to God lately? Talk to me about that.
Well, that's a hard one.
Oh, no, it's not. What have we been praying and praying for over the last few weeks? Haven't we been praying for Bella?
Oh, yes, we've been praying for Bella. Hey, Theo, we've been praying for Bella.
Oh, that's right. That's so exciting. It's been so exciting what's been happening.
I know. I saw her myself last week. We prayed. Yes, she was here. She came over. I saw her. She's doing so well. And we prayed and prayed for Bella's wing to be better. And everything has to be in God's plan. But, you know, he promised he'd be there for us, and he was. She had her surgery. She's going through, you know, her rehabilitation. But she's doing really well, isn't she?
Oh, that's really true. I didn't even think about it. Our prayers made a difference, and she's doing fantastic.
We went to God, and you know, we prayed to God, we asked him, and he was there for us, and now Bella is doing really well. Isn't that terrific?
So God told us to pray for Bella, and we did, and he answered.
Oh, that's so cool. That's so cool.
God is wonderful.
He is. Should we say it together?
All right. No, I can't do it.
Great, I'll do it, Freddy. God is so wonderful.
So wonderful. God really is so wonderful. Well, guys, I'm so glad that you came here. Next time you come over, though, it'd be really great if you didn't try to knock down the house, though, okay?
Oh, we promise, MJ.
Yes, I promise. I won't ever do that again unless I ask you.
Okay, that's good. Ask first. That's good. Before you do things like that, it would be great if we talk about it first. That's great. Okay, guys, thanks so much for coming over. Let's wave goodbye to the kids.
Bye, kids.
Bye, kids. Love you.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
What a great day of learning about how God is wonderful. I loved getting to see all those different ways that God is wonderful and learn about that phrase, hallowed be thy name, how we get to talk to a God who inspires awe and wonder, whose name is holy and amazing. So we're back in Kathleen's Question Corner this week, and I've got my Bible. Professor Doug will not be making an appearance today because he's in the middle of nap time. But today I'm going to answer a really important question from Nora Kay, which is God really real? And this is an important question because if God's not real, then why would we pray to him? I just want to give a couple thoughts about why, how we know that God is really real. There are a couple things, right? There are some head ways that we know, some ways, some facts, some knowledge. And there are some ways we know through our heart. Some head thoughts is there's a rule in science about how energy cannot come from nothing. Everything in the world is made up of energy, and it can never just come from somewhere else. Anytime energy is used, it's converted into a different type of energy. And so when scientists talk about this, it points to this idea that maybe there is an intelligent creator, God, who created everything in the whole universe. We also think about how our universe was made, how we're just the right distance from the sun, how the earth is tilted at just the right amount on its axis, and how the air is just the right that we need to be able to breathe. The odds of the earth being made this way so that we could live on it are incomprehensible for that fact. And it points to this idea that God designed and made the earth special for us. And I also think about the way that we're designed all the way down into our smallest molecules, into our DNA. God thoroughly thought through. And the more I learn about how God made us, the more amazed I am that we could have been, there's no way we could have been made any other way but how God made us. I also, so that's some head things, some heart stuff is how God speaks to us, right? It's the feelings I get inside of me of warmth when God talks to me or shares something with me. It's when I'm praying to God and sometimes I can hear him speaking back to me. It's unexplainable things and miracles that could have only been done by God himself, right? I think about the walls of Jericho coming down. There was no explanation for that except for God producing a huge miracle. And then there's this verse in Revelation. It's Revelation 5:13, and it says, "Then I heard every creature in heaven and on earth and under the earth and in the sea. They sang, blessing and honor and glory and power belong to the one sitting on the throne and to the Lamb forever and ever." And so sometimes just when I look out at the beautiful world that's been made, I can't help but think about how wonderful and amazing God is to have created all of that. The Bible even says that one day all creatures and all the mountains will all cry out and worship God because he's so wonderful, right? That's the reason, because God is wonderful, we worship him and we talk to him and pray to him. And isn't it amazing that a wonderful God wants to talk to you? Right? He wants to have a personal relationship with you and talk to you. Let's pray to him right now. God, we thank you for who you are, that your name is hallowed and holy and sacred. We thank you that you're wonderful and that you want to talk to us anytime and that you are really real. In your name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Give us our debts as we forgive.